Hello, welcome to Accounting Hub. I'm Professor George Scarpin, PhD in accounting, and our topic today is revaluation of plant assets. And revaluation, it is not allowed in the US. So we are talking only about IFRS. And even on IFRS countries, there are some countries that don't allow it. So check your local accounting regulation to check if it is allowed in your country or not, okay? So what is revaluation of plant assets? IFRS allows company to revalue plant assets to fair value at the reporting date. So you can do it every year if you want to. Must be applied to all assets in a class of assets. And assets that are experienced rapid price changes must be revalued on an annual basis. So if it is experienced rapid price changes, you must do it. If not, you can do it or not. So how do we do that? Let's go to our Excel file. Wow, too small here. Better. Okay. Let's do it together. So Scarpin Corporation, my fake company, applies revaluation to equipment purchased on January 1st, 2020 for 1 million euros. The equipment has a useful life of 5 years and no residual value. And we work with straight line depreciation, only to make it easier, okay? So what do we do? So purchase price, $1 million, useful life, 5 years. So the depreciation expense, how do we do that? Purchase price less residual value, no residual value, so less nothing, divided by useful life. And let's delete it for now. So what do we have here? We are at the end of the first year. So we have 1 year of depreciation expense. So debit depreciation expense, credit accumulated depreciation. So we have here accumulated depreciation. Okay, and equipment here when we purchase it. At the end of 2020, independent appraisers determined that the asset has a fair value of 850,000 euros. So let's check if we have a gain or a loss. So before fair value, what do we have? Equipment, 1 million euros. Less accumulated depreciation, 200,000 euros. So our book value will be 800. So our book value, 800. Our fair value, 850. So we have a gain. When we have a gain, we call it revaluation surplus. So how much is it? Fair value, 850. Book value, 800. And how do we find this fair value here? Here, each country has its own rules. Based on market value, discounted cash flow, both. So usually it is one of those two or both. So market value less expenses to sell it or discounted future cash flows. Okay. So the revaluation surplus. Here we have $50,000. So what is our journal entry? So it is just like now we are selling our old asset and we are under quote here purchasing a new asset. So if we are selling it, we have no more accumulated depreciation. So accumulated depreciation, $200,000, and this journal entry is closed. Here we have a gain. So if we have a gain, we have a credit. So revaluation surplus, and here it is not a revenue. It is other comprehensive income. It is in our equity. And then equipment is the number to balance. So it is 150. How do we know if this journal entry is right? the new and imbalance of equipment must be the fair value 100% of the time. And it doesn't matter if you are talking about gain or losses, that is exactly the same. Okay? What about if we have a loss? So what do we have here? Oh, too small. Yes. The same numbers here. However, the fair value is 750 now instead of 850. So, okay, our book value will be the same, 200. And here, what do we have? Fair value, 750. Less book value, 800. Oh, it's not revaluation surplus here. It is impairment loss. And impairment loss here. And the journal entry is the same. Accumulated depreciation, 200. Now we have a loss, and this loss is an expense. So it is not other comprehensive income. Again, check your local regulations, but usually it is an expense. So impairment loss debit, because it is a loss, 50. And equipment is the number to balance. So it is the sum credit, 250. Now, the new ending balance of equipment must be the fair value. And then in 2021, I depreciate this new equipment here. And then the useful life, instead of 5 years, will be 4 years and so on. Okay? So, guys, that's it. Please subscribe our channel. You will be the first one to know when a new video arrives. Like our Facebook page, Accounting Hub by Dr. Scarpin. Like this video. If you have any questions or comments, leave it here or email me at jscarpin@gmail.com. Have a very nice day and God bless you.